Don't touch that dial, because there's nothing else on. You might just as well listen to Blondie. Blondie, rebroadcast for the servicemen and women of the United Nations, with Penny Singleton and Arthur Lake as Blondie and Dagwood Bumpstead, respectively.
And now for our weekly visit with our neighbors, the Bumpsteads of Shady Lane Avenue. Well, just at the moment, things are very quiet this afternoon at the Bumpstead home. That moment just passed, and now there's going to be a little action. In just a second, the phone is going to ring. There we are. And here comes Blondie to answer it.
Oh, dear. Now, I wonder who that could be. I just talked to Cora Dithers an hour ago. Hello?
Blondie, is that you?
Oh, yes, Dagwood. Oh, my goodness, it's hot today. Where are you?
I'm in jail.
Well, I hope it isn't as hot there as it is here, because it's in jail.
I've been arrested.
What for? Jaywalking? Did you rob?
The First National Bank. No. I mean, that's the one they think I robbed yesterday afternoon. I'm innocent, Blondie. Listen, will you come right down here right away and get me out of jail? I'm not happy here.
All right, Dad, but I'll get Mr. Gibbs to meet you there. I'll call him right out.
Okay, honey. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
J.C. Dennis Construction Company. Office of J.C. Dennis, president of the J.C. Dennis Construction Company. J.C. Dennis saying hello.
Hello, Mr. Dennis.
Oh, hello, Blondie. Say, do you know where Dagwood is? He should be in the office working.
He's in jail.
Oh. But wait. Who gave him permission to go there? He robbed a bank on Dithers Company time. He was supposed to be working for me, not himself.
But wasn't he working for you yesterday afternoon?
Why, that's right. He was in the office all afternoon.
Well, then he couldn't have robbed the bank.
Why, of course not. Listen, I'll meet you down at the jail, Blondie, and we'll get him right out.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Dithers. I knew you'd be anxious to help.
Oh, I'm not anxious to help. But every minute he spends loafing in that nice, cool jail is costing me money. Goodbye.
Well, Dagwood, now that you're free, just relax.
Yeah.
And enjoy your chocolate soda.
Yeah.
And tell us what happened.
Yeah, why should they think you'd want to rob a bank?
Yeah.
They know, you know as I know, that crime doesn't pay.
Yeah, but do they know as I know that the business company doesn't pay either?
Bumpstead.
Huh?
Don't be so ungrateful. Now explain things.
Yeah, well, Blondie, you know what I've been telling you about the dreams I've been having lately.
Oh, yes. It's sort of interesting, Mr. Dithers.
Mm.
Dagwood's been dreaming things that come true later.
Yeah, that's right, Mr. Dithers.
Ho, ho, ho. And who makes your dreams come true? A fairy godmother, precious?
Oh, cut it out, J.C.
Well, then be sensible.
Mr. Dithers, don't you dare say another word until I find out why they arrested Dagwood on suspicion of bank robbery. Now, go ahead, Jack.
Yeah. Well, the other night, I dreamt that the First National Bank would be held up. So, when I went in there yesterday morning, I told Mr. Hoop, the cashier...
He did?
Yeah. That the bank was going to be held up in the afternoon. He wasn't much amused, particularly after he got held up. I guess he told the police what I said, and they grabbed me this morning.
Oh. Well, what are some of these other dreams you've been having?
Well, Dad would dream that the Acme Market would sell me some clothespins. And sure enough, they did.
That's practically a miracle.
Yeah. And you know that property that the Hamilcar Company bought for their factory last week?
Yes, what about it?
I dream they did it a week before they did it.
Good grief, Bumpstead.
Yeah.
Well, why didn't you buy the property yourself and make a profit?
See, I never dreamed about that. I never thought about it either.
What a dope.
Yeah.
What a nitwit.
Yeah. Oh, please, Mr. Dithers. Remember, you are talking about my dream man.
Yes. Yeah.
A nightmare, I call him.
Now, Dagwood, why didn't you buy that property yourself?
Now, well, how could I tell the dream was coming true? After all, last night I dreamt that today Mr. Dithers would find a $10 bill. And you haven't found one, have you, J.C.?
Well, have you, Mr. Dithers?
No. No, I haven't.
Yeah, and the same night I dreamt that Blondie bought a pair of nylons at the little place right next door here to this drugstore.
Nylons? Next door?
Yeah.
Well, I don't believe it. Goodbye.
Oh, of course. This whole thing is ridiculous. We all know that.
Yeah.
I hope.
This is a good soda.
Whoops! There goes my spoon. Good grief.
Huh?
Bumstead.
What?
Look what I found.
Holy smoke, a $10 bill.
Your dream came true.
Yeah.
Hey, Bumstead, you can see into the future.
Oh, now that's silly, J.C. That's silly. How can I see into the future without a crystal ball?
Why, this is amazing.
Yeah.
There's a fortune in it. Stock market, real estate, oil wells, bingo. Dagwood, old friend.
Huh?
I want to make you a proposition.
You do?
That's right, Daggy. Old friend of mine.
Mr. Dithers, whenever you smile and call me an old friend of yours, I know you've got larceny in your heart.
Oh, bum.
You're trying to figure out some way of swindling me out of something, and I'll be a sucker as usual.
I suppose so, so let's get down to business.
Yeah.
I want to buy exclusive rights to all your dreams and the contents thereof.
Hmm. And would that mean I'd have to ask your permission to have a dream?
No, I wouldn't think so.
Hmm.
But you'll have to tell me what your dreams are about whenever you have them. Hmm. Well, what do you say, Daggy, old buddy?
Well, Divvy, old fuddy-duddy, you haven't mentioned any sum of money yet, as per the party of the second part, ipso facto.
Yes, money.
Yeah.
Well, I'll give you $5 a week for your dream.
Well, I don't know. $5 a week seems like...
$10, then.
Well, okay. Gee, I was just going to say that $5 a week seems like a lot for my dreams.
Oh, well, don't worry, Bumstead. Oh, I'm going to make a fortune on your dreams. I'm going to make so much money there'll be even some left after I pay taxes on it. And believe me, that's a lot of money. I wouldn't have believed this could happen if I hadn't found that
$10. Look, I bought 3 pairs of nylons.
Good grief.
Oh, holy smoke.
Hey, my dream was right again. They fallen down behind the shelf, and the saleswoman had just found them, and they didn't happen to be her size.
Yeah, oh.
Bumstead.
Huh?
Don't forget that you sold me the rights to your dreams for $10 a week.
Oh, Dagwood, it's worth 25 or 50 times as much.
Well, Blondie, he hasn't paid me any money yet to bind the contract.
Oh, here's $20 in advance.
No, take it.
Take it.
Dagwood.
Bumstead.
Well, I promised I'd take the dough.
That's the stuff, Dagwood. Now, go and pay for the soda.
Thank you. I'll be right back. Here, boy, $20.
Now, see here, Mr. Dithers.
Now, Blondie, don't try to talk me out of my contract with him. He's stuck with it. Boy, I'm going to make a fortune out of this. And he can't tell his dreams to anyone but me.
Mr. Dithers, did you ever stop to think that Dagwood might talk in his sleep?
What? Uh-oh.
I hate to be mercenary, but I'm the businessman in our house, and I expect to be cut in on my husband's dreams. And if you don't want to cooperate with me, I'll just listen in when Dagwood talks in a creep and sell the information to someone else.
Oh, Blondie, is that fair?
Certainly. A dream with a lot of inside information could be very valuable. Now, let's really talk business, Mr. Dithers.
Well, I'll give you 10% of all I make from Dagwood's dreams.
Mr. Dithers, I want 75%.
75? Why, that's ridiculous. The most I'd ever give you is 50%.
So?
I wonder if I spoke too soon.
Well, it's all paid for, Blondie. I guess I didn't tell you, J.C., about another dream I had last night. It was very exciting.
What was it? Betty Grable?
Oh, Oh, no. The annual boat race between the east side and the west side. Boy, what a race.
Why, Dagwood, that race is tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah, I know it.
Say, I just thought of something. Why, this will be worth a fortune to me.
Yeah, what's that, Mr. Bibby?
Well, Cora's been thinking about where we're going for our vacation.
Ah.
It's the same old business, the seashore or the mountains. Cora wants to go to the mountains and look at the scenery.
And you want to go to the seashore and look at the girls.
Yeah. No! Well, let's face it, I'm human.
That's news to me.
Bumstead!
Yeah, excuse me.
Mr. Githers, what does your vacation have to do with Dagwood's dreams and the boat race tomorrow?
Well, Dagwood will tell me which side won the race in his dreams. Then I'll get Cora to bet with me that if the side I pick wins the race, I can choose where we go for our vacation.
Oh.
Oh, this is going to be wonderful.
Yeah, it is a swell idea, Mr. Gittick, but it has one tiny little weakness.
Oh, what's that?
In my dream, I didn't see who won the race.
Oh, Dagwood, why was that?
Well, just as both boats drew towards the finish line and everyone was cheering and yelling and screaming.
Uh-huh. Yes, what happened?
The alarm clock went off.
Oh, dear. Huh? Is that all you remember about the race?
Well, Bobby, you made me get out of bed, and I haven't learned yet how to continue my dream and brush my teeth at the same time.
Say,
huh?
Maybe he can dream the race all over again. Dagwood, how do you feel right now?
Right now?
Yes.
Well, I feel fine, thank you. Very chipper and wide awake.
Well, don't you feel a little drowsy? I am practically asleep myself.
Yes, Dagwood, after your experience in jail, wouldn't you like to get up? Oh, that one. Excuse me. I'm not a bit sleepy.
Or am I?
Dagwood, we'd better take you right home and let you float off to Dreamland.
Oh, no. I couldn't sleep when I ought to be working for Mr. Githers.
Oh, it's all right with me, Dagwood.
Oh, no. I just couldn't sleep on the couch on company time.
Oh, why not? You sleep at your desk on company time. Constantly.
Oh, please, Dagwood.
Well, all right, okay. I'm willing to lie down on the couch and rest my eyes a little bit, but I positively, absolutely refuse to go to sleep, and that's final.
I can't stand to listen to much more of this. I'm getting sleepy myself.
So am I. Oh, wait, I think he said something.
Oh, boy, look at him go.
Wow! Oh, it sounds like he's dreaming of the boat race, all right.
Oh, this is wonderful. I've always wanted to be able to decide where to go on my vacation. But it's impossible when you're married.
Mr. Githers, you know, I never force Dagwood to go where I want to go for a vacation.
You don't?
Mm-mm. I just say, Dagwood, I'm going to the mountains. Do you want to come along? And he always says yes.
Women are so sweet and reasonable.
Here they come! Wow!
Oh, it must be the race, all right.
Yeah, Bumstead, watch that race.
Right.
Oh, please see which boat wins.
Right.
Dagwood, who won? Who won the race? Who won the race?
Boy, I sure was dreaming, wasn't I, huh?
Dagwood, did you dream about the boat race again? The race that's going to be held tomorrow afternoon?
Yeah, that's right. I did.
Oh, what a race.
The guys in each boat were roaring like mad right up to the finish.
Did you see the finish?
No, I turned away to get a hot dog and missed it.
Bumstead! Let me at it.
Please, Mr. Githers, don't.
I've got to get off, and I've got to.
Oh, you, dribbling, drooling, drip.
Oh! Mr. Githers, you forced me to get tough about this.
Oh! Bonnie, let go of my ear.
Well, all right, you let go of Dagwood's cheese on first.
Yeah.
If you're going to be sensitive about it.
That's better. Yeah,
oh,
thanks.
Bumstead.
Huh?
This is the only chance I've ever had to take a vacation where I want to take it. The only chance in years and years and years.
Now, go don't cry, Mr. Diggy.
Oh, I just can't help it. Now then, will you please go back to sleep again?
No, I'm wide awake now.
Oh, Jag, but you've got to go back to sleep. Mr. Diggers wants to know whether the east side boat or the west side boat is going to win. Now, dear, please see if you can't take another little nap.
No, I couldn't do it now, Blondie.
Mom says, I haven't said so to sleep.
No, I can't possibly.
Well, I'm not going to stand for any more foolishness.
Huh?
Put your big fat head down on that pillow.
Now, wait a minute.
Come on, close your broken down eyes.
Yeah, wait.
Now, go to sleep.
Yeah,
And if you're not off in 10 minutes, I'll come back and rock you to sleep with a rock.
I think he's sleeping in there, Mr. Diggers. Let's go in, but be very quiet.
All right, Blondie. Oh, I hope he remembers which boat wins the race this time. I've got to win that bet with Cora.
Oh. The poor darling is sound asleep.
The poor darling. Oh, shit.
Mr. Diggers, be careful. Don't step on Daisy's tail.
Don't what on whose way? Get off onto my foot, you low-bred, squalling, ill-tempered flea farm.
Who, me? What's going on here?
Get back to your sleeping, Bumstead.
Oh, Mr. Diggers, get off Daisy's tail.
Get out of this room before I kick you out.
Oh, no! Hey, Mr. Diggers, now, don't kick Daisy. Now, stop that. Hey, boy, kick him, Daisy, get him.
Come on, get him, Daisy.
Hey, look out. Help! Take over my leg, you mutt. Help! I'm calling! Help!
Oh, Mr. Diggers, stop teasing Daisy. You only get her excited.
Oh, scratch your eyes. Mom said, what were you dreaming about?
It was sort of about the river race.
Oh, good. Who won?
Well, I wasn't really dreaming about the race, Mr. Diddick. I was just dreaming that I was dreaming about it. So it wasn't a real dream, but a dream of a dream.
Oh.
Yes, you see? Do you understand?
Oh, sure. I understand. Perfectly.
Yeah.
It couldn't be any clearer. There's only one thing to do now.
What's that?
Come on, Bumstead.
Huh?
Get on my lap. Oh, goodbye, Bumstead. Oh, my lap. Oh, that was a nice dinner, Blondie.
Oh, thank you.
I wonder where Dagwood is.
You know, Mr. Diggers, I wouldn't be surprised if Dagwood was taking a little after-dinner nap right now.
I wouldn't be surprised either. I know he's taking a nap.
Well, as a matter of fact, I know he'll take a nap, too. You see, I put a sleeping pill in his glass of milk.
You did?
Mm-hmm. Was that wrong?
I don't know. I dosed up his milk, too.
Oh, how many pills did you put in?
I don't know exactly. It was a sort of a level handful. I just wanted to be sure I'd send him to Slumberland.
Mommy!
Oh, what is it, Cookie?
Daddy's on the couch honking his horn.
He's what?
You know, snoring.
Oh.
Sound asleep.
So soon? Why, he just laid down a minute ago.
I know he's sound asleep. Didn't wake up when I hit him in the face with my Raggedy Ann doll.
Are you sure he wasn't really awake and just pretending to be asleep?
Yep. I hit him again to make sure.
Oh, Mr. Diggers, we'd better go right in and see if he's all right.
Oh, he'll be all right. Those pills are pretty weak.
Well, I don't know about that.
Oh, listen to those beautiful pear-shaped snores. He sounds like a frog with a man in his throat.
Mr. Dithers, I'm worried about this. I'm going to wake him up and see if he feels all right.
Oh, now, Blondie, don't do that.
Oh, but I don't want to take any chances. Dagwood! Dagwood, now wake up. Wake up, dear.
Yeah, Bumstead, wake
up. Dagwood. Good morning, honey.
Good morning, precious.
Oh, he's really out. I'm going to shake him. Dagwood, wake up. Oh, Dagwood, wake up.
Hello, Mr. Dithers.
Oh, I'm not Mr. Dithers, Dagwood.
Stop shaking me, Mr. Dithers.
Oh, Dagwood.
I'll handle him, Blondie. I'll get close and yell in his ear. Bumstead! Get out of it. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Good night, darling.
Oh, dear, he's asleep again. Mr. Dithers, why don't you come back tomorrow and we'll see if he's dreamed about the race.
Oh, all right, Blondie. But I'm beginning to wonder if it's worth it. Bumstead, wake up. It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon. The race is going to start any minute.
Those sleeping pills really worked on him. He was awake a couple of times this morning, but he fell right off to sleep again.
Good grief. 2 o'clock. The race has started. I've got to call Cora and make my bet with her.
But you don't know which boat Dagwood dreamed would be the winner.
Oh, well, Blondie, hand me that pitcher of ice water.
Oh, Mr. Dithers, do you really think you should?
How can you ask that when you're shoving the pitcher right into my hand?
Well, time's wasting. Or he'll make an awful yell.
Well, it's for a good cause. Me.
I'm drowning. Help! Get the ice burn off my back. Help! I've been bird-eyed.
Blondie, get Cora on the phone right away.
Oh, all right, Mr. Dithers.
Oh, Dagwood, which boat won the race in your dream?
Huh?
The east side or the west side boat?
Good morning, Mr. Dithers.
It's good afternoon. Who won?
Yes. Well, the way I dreamed it, the race was won by...
Good afternoon, Dagwood.
Good afternoon, honey.
Well, haven't you got a good morning kiss for me this afternoon?
Oh, sure, of course I have.
Oh, for the love of Pete, can't that gooner stuff wait until I find out who won?
No, here, take the phone.
Yeah, here's your kiss, darling.
Oh, hello, Cora. I'll tell you the boat I'm betting on as soon as I can pry Dagwood away from Blondie. Oh, come on, folks. Break it out.
Oh, excuse us, Mickey.
Excuse us.
Now, who won, Dagwood? I've got Cora hanging on the other end of this phone.
Now, let me think for a minute.
You know, they're going to signal the winner today with one shot from the cannon if the east side wins and two for the west side. We'll be able to tell right away. Now, hurry up.
Wait a minute. Now I remember. I remember who won.
Okay, Cora.
Yes.
And remember that if my boat comes in, we go to the seashore for our vacation. What is it, Dagwood?
The Navy boat won.
The Navy boat, Cora. Yes. Call you later. Well, I guess that's all. And I've got nothing to... The Navy boat?
Yes.
What did I say? There's only an east side boat and a west side boat.
Oh, wait, Mr. Dithers.
Bumstead, what have you done to me?
I think I'll go back to sleep again.
I know you are. I'm going to shove you to sleep.
Mr. Dithers. There was something in the paper this morning about there being a possibility of a Navy boat being entered. Some of the boys who are sailors got together and were going to rent a boat to row in the race.
Yeah, that's the way it was in my dream.
Huh? One shot. The east side boat won.
No. The west side.
Hey, no. The sailors won. I know they won.
Yahoo! I'm going to the seashore at last. Oh, this is wonderful. Yeah. Come on, folks. Yahoo!
Oh, my goodness. Mr. Dithers certainly is pleased about winning the bet from Cora.
I just didn't have the heart to tell Mr. Dithers about the rest of my dream, Blondie.
Oh? What was that?
I dreamt that no matter whether Mr. Dithers won or not, Mrs. Dithers is still going to make him go to the mountains.